Hey guys, it's your girl Alicia, GeekXXChic, and we're back with another reaction to The Flash. I can talk, I swear to God. We're now on episode 9, which is called Timeless. So, last episode, we saw a very interesting twist of events where the Speed Force, for some reason, decided that all the other forces apparently need to be destroyed, and she did something we've never seen happen before where she actually went against Barry. Things are getting a little bit spicy now. Very interesting to see the Speed Force do something like this. Definitely raises a lot of questions as to whether or not this really is the same Speed Force. If there is some other subplot we're not picking up on, is there other factors we don't know of? There's just a lot of questions that came up with this actions, and obviously the ultimatum that she gave Barry at the end of the episode of choosing to take her side, aka do all these horrible things, or potentially take Iris's side or his own side, really, where he's just genuinely someone who's trying to help someone. So, interesting place to start the episode. Very eager to get into it, but before we do, you know the drill. If you've been here before and you like what you see, please go ahead and hit that subscribe button. That way you can be notified when I do more reactions to this show and other ones that are very similarly in the same comic-y, geeky vibe. So, hopefully you will join the fam. It's super fun here. All right, that out of the way, guys, let's get into the episode right about now. Is this helping me? I think so. Oh, I hate you, VLC. How are we going through this again?
She's dead.
Uh-oh.
You killed Alexa.
Barry and I did it together.
Someone call Amazon!
I'm supposed to protect lives, not destroy them!
That's right.
When you clean up your mess, Barry, this is your fault. The night you brought me back, you created these monsters. You and your lightning rod.
Oh! Oh no, this bitch gotta go. No, it's over.
My beautiful.
Don't make that creepy.
You have no choice.
Oh, I always because have a choice.
You don't, help me.
No.
No.
Good boy.
You have to help me,
Daddy! Ma'am. Iris is like, don't take this the wrong way, but your mama? She moving out the house. I'm putting her stuff out tonight.
What about what Nora said about you two creating the other forces?
There's no proof.
I mean, we are godlike. I think we totally could create gods, just saying.
Means the other three brand spanking new isotopic signatures.
Nora was right.
We created the forces.
I mean, you can't help it. Y'all be doing godlike things because you're amazing.
She killed the stranger.
Come on, it's been forever, boo.
We need to wipe the new forces out of existence.
Barry, what are you saying?
I want to go back in time.
No, this never goes well. Never, ever, 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 ever. Barry, have we learned nothing?
You're out a way to go back that doesn't affect the timeline.
Not possible.
It would be impossible.
Barry, look, I know that you're devastated about Nora. If you uncreate
her... We're only going to target the new forces, not Nora.
That's how do you know?
But if something goes wrong...
Thank you.
You lose your speed.
This is a bad plan.
Obviously, we disagree on this.
Yes, we do.
But you both have valid points.
I have to do it.
You don't. Queen Iris does not stand back or stand down, sir. You should know that.
Wait, Barry and I created these forces. What if there's a little bit of each of them inside of us? Like you're all connected.
Like they're your children?
Iris. Guys, we can use me as a divining rod to track her down. Yep, that's weird.
Iris is gonna be like, listen here, Nora, I'm your mama, okay? Both literally and figuratively.
Tweaking the tachyon enhancer. And then send out an EMP to 86 the forces. That's genius.
I gotta say, I actually really miss this, like seeing the three geniuses actually use their brains for once.
How we're supposed to do this.
It's almost like the show remembered that they're all smart.
How bad is it?
That depends on whether or not you can help us do the impossible.
As a matter of fact, that is what I minored in university. First, physics, next, the impossible.
So this gift, which has allowed me to relive every single day with Tess, but only because I took a chance.
I'm in.
So this is when Cisco's gonna decide to go to San Francisco with Camilla.
We've been trying to find the Speed Force when we should be looking for the person. So where would the real Nora Allen go?
The old Allen house?
Let me just run one more diagnostic on the collection disc.
Thank you for being thorough, since you seem to be one of the few people who's actually thinking. Oh God, why?
Sorry, who are you?
Who am I? Who are you? Who's he?
Why are we beefing? Calm down.
I think y'all are acting like that because you're afraid of me.
Well, you know, you're crazy.
So please let me fix it.
Fix it?
He likes it, duh. Fix it?
It's all my mistake.
Didn't say that.
You didn't have to.
Daddy's disappointed in you. Barry, why would you look at that?
Is that what you want to make it like I never existed?
Not you. Just the Force.
I am that Force.
Why is he always yelling? Dion needs anger management. That's what he needs. God. Ah, he aged it. Smart.
On this, yeah, we give up. Doesn't that feel like the right thing to do?
He's on Team Iris! Winning team!
Why can't you see? I'm trying to save him.
He doesn't want to be saved by you.
Don't save him. He don't want to be saved.
Yes, you're absolutely right. Something needs to be done about that.
But not this.
I don't have all the answers. All I know is...
Preach!
This can't be it.
That's all Iris was saying, Barry. That's all Iris was saying.
Harrison?
Harrison's like, I'm on vacation. You said your children, Barry. How does a father choose which child to live and die?
So it turns out.
Joe! Remember when Joe and Barry used to have conversations?
I mean, these forces, they're not my children.
You sure?
Right?
You said it yourself. You brought them into this world.
With Iris.
I know they've all done terrible.
Do we need to have a talk, Barry?
But what if they could you?
Hi, Mom.
No, don't call me that! Ah! I feel like this is the Spider-Man meme where they're like, they're both pointing at each other.
You're not real. There's no escaping your own fear. I know you're still here, Psych.
Exactly. I'm your mama.
We can help you regain control of your body.
What makes you think I'm not in control?
That's what I'm about to say. Like, some of these people are actually bad, Iris. Did it work? Who's laughing now, bitch? Or maybe something worse is gonna come in their place, like the Reverse Flash.
Judge kids who they are now.
Sage can be judged pretty hard though, actually. He's a psychopath.
Iris.
You were right, I'm sorry.
I'm sorry.
Yeah, me too.
You were right, no? Okay.
We can't judge Psych and Dion for who they are now.
Yeah, you can.
We have to help them become where they can grow up to be.
Guess that's what parents do.
Y'all are so cute. But can we not keep these dysfunctional children?
Is it crazy to think that we did this?
No! Hello! All the evidence has pointed to this! Look at them working together, creating magic and forces and stuff. Westallen magic, boo. Also, I just thought about how, like, wrong and weird it was that they had a dead body in Star Labs this whole time. And there we go. They're all like, yeah, kill it!
Man's gotta be where his heart lies. He's just gotta learn to listen to it.
Uh-huh. We get it. Cisco's leaving.
What are you gonna tell Team Flash?
Because I've been on the show for 7 years and they still haven't given me a proper storyline, so I'm leaving. Okay, bye. I feel like that should sum it up. No, this is so hurtful now because DMX. Y'all gonna work together? Y'all gonna fight?
What are you?
A reckoning.
Oh, damn. Yeah, you shouldn't be scared. When somebody calm and collected like that, it usually means bad things for you. Is it bad that I'm kind of loving Dark Nora a little bit? Just a little bit? Oh, goodness. Wow. Okay, so interesting approach at trying to deal with this whole multiple forces situation. We saw here that the Speed Force, aka Nora, it just feels like there is no other way to deal with these forces other than make her the only one the way that it was before. But understandably, Barry and Iris don't roll that way. Barry has always been about saving lives. He's the paragon of love. The idea of just killing people has never been okay with him, no matter what the situation is. But Nora kind of basically said to him, look, I'm only asking you as a courtesy. I will do this with or without you. So if you're on my side, great. If not, so be it. But she, you know, said a very interesting line about, you know, once I kill them all and you see how safe it is, you're going to see I was right. But Nora doesn't seem to be really that familiar yet with the way that human dynamics work where that's concerned. And also, apparently, she really didn't know Barry at all from before because she would know that that's not the way to get through to him. But that decision clearly pushed Barry to feeling like he had to do something equally dangerous and crazy, the first of which was traveling back in time, which, as you heard me screaming throughout the episode, has never gone well for Team Flash, particularly for Barry. But they have this new plot armor caveat through Wells, who's now this weird timeless being, where apparently he was able to go back and stop any flashpoints from being created while going and stopping these forces from being created. And I think the most interesting thing about this episode was the conversation that was being had around the idea of uncreating or wiping something out that already exists, thinking that that's going to be the answer. And it can be applied in a much broader sense, but I'm not going to get into the depths of that conversation so much as the idea that you can't really uncreate something, right? The speed forces, you know, force is just another word for energy. And if you know the physics law, energy can neither be created nor destroyed, although in this case, it technically was created. But one could argue that these forces existed all along and that potentially what happened that night in Star Labs was not so much the new forces being created, so much as them potentially being changed into different forces instead of just the speed force. The point is, you can't just uncreate them. And we saw that towards, you know, the end where Barry got back to that point in time, took out those particles that would have eventually created the forces that they know now. But even though he took the forces, yes, it destroyed what the avatars were that they chose, that original set of forces chose, but we saw that the forces themselves were still being created. Like, he couldn't stop that from happening. It kind of, again, lent itself to that physics idea that he couldn't uncreate it. It already happened. It already existed. All he would have done was change potentially the avatars that housed those particular powers. So, yes, Dion and whoever Psyche was and, what's her name, Alexa, would have disappeared, but the forces would have still been there and they simply would have chosen a new avatar. And quite frankly, as the expression goes, the devil that you know, it could have ended up being even worse this next time around, right? But one has to believe that since these forces, you know, as they've said in the episode, are apparently the result of Barry and Iris coming together and their love and their kinetic energy or whatever that created these forces, then one would also be able to say that there has to be something intrinsic in all of these hosts as to why these forces chose them. I think that the whole overall messaging around not judging the people that someone are, sorry, not judging people on who they are now, but their potential is a very deep message. I think it's a little bit broad. I mean, in the case of people like Psyche, Psyche is crazy. Psyche is a hurtful person. He clearly enjoys watching people suffer. That's not something that you can just ignore. I'm not saying he can't change, but at the moment, he's definitely more dangerous than not. Interesting messaging overall about, I feel like, family and parenthood and stuff like that. And I would love to think that maybe it's a precursor to Iris maybe eventually, please God, actually giving birth to our beautiful twins. But I've kind of given up on that dream for this show. I don't know if it's ever going to happen. I don't think they're ever going to give us Iris getting to be a mom, but they brought it up again in this episode. You know, Psych Force brought out the fact that one of her deepest fears is the fact that she still has not actually had a child. Like, we all know about the Nora thing, but that really wasn't the Iris of today. So I'm hoping again that they've mentioned it a couple times and had this whole theme around parenthood, that they actually allow Iris to become a human mother, not just a mother of Speed Forces and of gods. But I mean, you gotta admit, that's kind of a flex though. Like, so she's like, some people have babies, I give birth to gods or whatever. But anyway, I'm hoping that that's something that we get at least before the show ends forever. Speaking of things ending forever, I did see the notes that some people put out there that Carlos Valdez apparently has confirmed that he is no longer going to be on the show, that he's leaving this season. And I'm not surprised. I'm sad in the sense of I love Cisco's character. I love Carlos. I think he's so talented and just amazing, but I completely understand this decision. There's really no other way to put it. Like, Carlos is such a good actor. Cisco is such a cool character with his own rich, deep history and storyline. And the fact that the show just completely just sidestepped. Like, it's like they went out of their way not to give Cisco his own storyline, his own growth and development, his own real trajectory on this show, and there is really no reason for it. I completely understand that decision. I'm super sad about it, but on the other hand, like, sad in the sense of I will miss Cisco's character, but I do think this is the best move for Carlos, honestly. As much as I will miss him, I wish him the absolute best, and I thank him for all of the amazing work that he's done on The Flash all these years. And I look forward to whatever else he's going to do next, because I know he will slay it, and hopefully it will be an opportunity that is actually worthy of him and that appreciates the amazing talent that he's going to bring. That's pretty much it, I think, for this episode. There's not much else to get into. I'm not even going to talk about the Speed Force versus Dion thing. I don't really know where they're going with this. We'll have to see where it goes, but yeah, other than that, it was pretty fun to watch. So if you've watched along with me to this point, guys, thank you so much. Please hit that thumbs up button. Let me know that you liked it. And if you want to see more from this geeky face, please click subscribe. Until next time, see ya.